Hello guys, welcome back to CINEMATION. Today, we'll be watching the movie, That's My Boy. Beware of spoilers. The film begins at a school in 1984. We see Donny, a popular teenager in his school. Donny is interested in girls and his friends begin to talk to him. His friends tell him that he doesn't want to be a girl his age. He wants real women. We then meet the teacher at his school. Her beauty attracts every boy in the school. Mary is her name. Donny has two concert tickets. He asked Mary if Mary would like to go with him. Mary informs him that she's not his girlfriend and that asking teachers to date her is inappropriate. Donny continues to flirt with her. Mary gave him a month of detention. Mary begins to seduce Donny in the detention room. She tells him she was really roused and seduced by him. Donny isn't sure if this is true. Mary then takes Donny to her office, and the affair begins. Their affair continues for a long time. They even meet outside of school. One day, a school program is being held in the auditorium. The whole school hears something. They are so curious that they open the curtains to find Donny, Mary, and their children. All of school is shocked at what they have seen. Mary runs away in shame. Donny receives cheers from the entire school. He even seems to enjoy it. Mary is brought to court for her sexual relationship with her student. The court discovers that Mary is actually pregnant by Donny's baby. Mary is sentenced to 30 years in prison. Donny is a celebrity because he inseminated his teacher. His interview is taken by many news stations and he is invited to many shows, which makes him a millionaire. 28 years later, Donny's life takes a different turn. He has become an alcoholic and has spent all of the money here as well as the fame that he gained from his immunization of Mary. His friend informs him that he hadn't paid taxes for years. The government owed him $43,000. He will be sent to jail if he does not pay. Donny doesn't have any money. Donny has only $20 left. He is suggested by a friend to place that money on a fat man who would run a marathon. The odds of the fat guy winning were 8,000 to 1. Donny believes he has nothing left to lose and that the money is his only loss. He is asked by his friend if he could get the money from his son. Donny says that his son had left him when he was 18 years old, and they haven't spoken to each other since. This is the son who came after Mary gave birth. He called him Han Solo. We now see Han Solo. However, he has changed his name from Todd to Han Solo. He is going to marry Jamie, his beautiful girlfriend. Donny quickly learns about the news of his marriage from the newspapers. Surprised to see his son lose weight and his name change. His son, meanwhile, is now a millionaire. Todd kept his parents' information secret after he left Donny. He told the media that his parents had died in an accident. Donny is furious and Todd takes Todd's girlfriend's parents to the house of his boss. They were allowed to stay there until the wedding by their boss. He also meets Jamie's soldier brother at the house. He is Chad, and he tells Todd to not hurt his sister. Donny then goes to Vanilla Ice, his friend, to ask for help with the money. Vanilla Ice isn't willing to help Donny because he had slept with his mom. So, Ice attacks Donny. Later, he asks a TV producer for help. The producer tells him that he can't help him and that people aren't interested in him anymore. Donny suggests that they interview Donny and Mary, who are soon to be released from prison. He wants more. Donny asks about Todd's son. Donny responds that Todd was extremely successful and wealthy. This is what I heard. Donny is told by the producer that if he brings his child and has an interview with Mary and him, he will give him $50,000. Donny considers the money and goes to meet Todd. Donny then goes to Jimmy's house to meet him. Todd is shocked to see Donny at his house. Todd is nervous and introduces Donny to Todd as his friend, not his father. Todd begins to pretend Donny is his friend and starts making up stories. Donny is a good sport and tells him strange stories. Everyone believes him. Todd believes that Donny should go, but everyone wants Donny to stay. Donny is allowed to stay at the wedding. Todd later gets mad at Donny and asks him why. Donny refuses to tell Todd about the interview. He then lies to Donny that his mother is really ill and that he must see her before the surgery. Todd isn't convinced. They get into an argument. Donny thinks he was a great dad, but Todd claims that Donny is the worst parent in all of the world. Jamie calls Todd to discuss the cocktail party. Todd asks Donny to wear a tie, but Donny tells him that it is not his style. After Todd offers $100, Donny agrees, and he does. Tony arrives at the party wearing a tie, but no pants. Jamie introduces Donny and Todd to Todd's boss. They get along quickly. Donny amazes everyone with his fake stories. One of the guests even recognizes Donny as the student who got his teacher pregnant. Todd's boss recognizes him then and asks about his son with his teacher. As he looks at Todd, Donny says that his son was rude and spoiled. Although everyone at the party knew Johnny, no one knew that Todd was his son, Todd's friend and co-worker. Todd said that Todd should not be the best man because they are close friends. Donny should be Todd's best man. He says, Todd insists that it's not necessary, but Donny accepts the offer. Donny then proposes to play baseball. Todd is the only one who isn't excited about this idea. Everybody in the field is great at the sport, even grandma and little child. Todd isn't athletic. Donny bats the ball toward Todd, but he fails to catch it. Everyone believes that Todd is a loser. Jamie told Todd about Johnny's book that Donny had written. It contained a message from his son. After seeing this, Todd is moved to tears. Jamie also wants to go to bed with Todd, but he doesn't want the dress to be damaged. Jamie's friends invite her to the bachelorette party next day. Danny wants to know if Todd is hosting a bachelor party. Todd's friend claims that he has organized everything. Donny isn't happy to learn that the bachelor party also included a spa treatment. This is his worst bachelor party. He encourages them all to go to a strip club, and they all do. They all have a great time at a strip club. Todd seems to have a lot of fun at his bachelor party. Donny takes everyone to his house, and he talks with Todd as he wants more time with him. As a wedding gift, Danny gives Todd the mother's earring. Todd appears happy, but he doesn't have a pierced ears. Donny then pierces Todd's ear and places the earring in his ear. Todd is shocked to learn that Uncle Vinny was Vanilla Ice. They have a great time and become even more close friends. Todd is very happy and enjoys the night. It was over. Todd tells Donny that he will visit his mother in jail. Donny is aware that he should not use his son to make money. Their bond seems to be strengthening after they spent a special night together. Donny isn't willing to take the risk for money. Todd hears Donny say that his mother had lied about being sick so he doesn't have to visit her. They hugged and went to bed. Donny discovers Todd's boss's mom in his bedroom, and Todd continues to have an affair with a mannequin. The next morning, Jamie discovers that Todd had purged all over her dress. She claims that something is wrong with her dress. She tries it on and discovers that Todd attempted to have sex in her dress. Donny is proud to hear this and is proud of Todd. Jamie insists that Todd fix the dress before their wedding. Todd heads to dry cleaning, and Donny calls him to inform him that he is going to meet his mother. Donny tries unsuccessfully to stop Todd, but Todd insists that he wants his mother to come to him. Donny rushes to get to the jail, but Todd tells him not to let Todd know about the interview. Todd was to be paid $50,000. Donny arrives at the jail to find Todd waiting for him to meet his mother. Todd is told by Donny that he shouldn't waste time before the wedding. Mary turns up. Although she is older, her attitude hasn't changed much. Mary is delighted to see Donny and Todd. Todd seems to be happy that he finally saw his mother after so long. Donny is captivated by Mary's presence, and both of them get quite nasty over the phone. Todd clearly disgusts at them. The TV producer arrives with a camera to ask Todd questions. He realizes that Donny returned to his life in order to obtain this interview to make some money. Todd is furious and decides to leave Donny. Donny realizes that Todd made a mistake when he returned to Todd's house. Donny is ready to leave, but he hears Jamie talk to Steve, Todd's boss. Jamie said that Todd would never know. Donny discovers that Jamie has been cheating on Todd and his boss. The wedding rehearsal. Todd is there to hear everything from Donny. Todd won't listen to what he has to say. Donny tells Todd about Jamie's affair with his boss. Jamie opens up and tells everyone she planned a surprise for Todd. She claims that Donny misjudged the whole conversation. Donny realizes that he has made a mistake and he is able to get out of trouble. After the rehearsal, Jamie and her younger brother get in a car and leave Todd and their parents alone. Donny observes the lesson from afar and contemplates how he could make things right. Donny's friends suggest that he apologize to Jamie first. Donny then gets two ice creams and then goes to Jamie to apologize. But outside the room, he hears Jamie have sex. Todd was clearly left behind. So, who is she sleeping with now? Donny enters Jamie's room to find Todd cheating. He soon discovers that Jamie was actually sleeping with Chad, her brother. Donny is stunned to see this. Donny is disgusted at Chad's incestuous relationship with Jamie. He snaps a photo of them together and states that he will tell Todd everything. Jamie, however, offers to pay him money. Jamie promises to give him the money he requires if he doesn't shut up and tell Todd everything. Donny is desperate, so he accepts the money. Next day, Donny is ashamed of the things he did. He realizes that there is still time before the wedding. He goes to Vanilla Ice and requests his car. Vanilla Ice and Donny go on a ride together to crash the wedding. Todd has accepted the marriage vows. Donny arrives just in time to stop everything and interrupts the ceremony. Todd is shocked to see Donny ruining his wedding. Danny points out Jamie and states that his son cannot marry such a woman. Donny calls Todd his child in front of everyone. Jamie was shocked to learn that Todd was the result of a sexual relationship between a student and a teacher. Donny accuses her of cheating on Todd. Jamie refuses to be accused, but Donny gives everyone the check Jamie gave him to stop blaming others. Danny even tore the check, proving that his son was more important than the money. Jamie tells Todd all about Chad sleeping with her and suggests that they get married because they are both imperfect. Todd is disgusted that Jamie had been sleeping with her brother. At the wedding, he tells everyone about Chad's relationship with Jamie. Needless to say, everyone is also disgusted. Chad then blames Jamie for everything and walks away. Jamie then apologizes to Todd and asks him to accept his daughter. Todd turns to his father and Vanilla Ice, who are both shaking their heads. Todd realizes his worth, and he says no to Jamie. He cancels the wedding, and probably tells everyone his father was Donny. Todd tells his boss that Todd is quitting his job. Vanilla Ice tells Todd that his boss had been sleeping with Jamie. Although his boss attempts to deny it, Todd informs him that Vanilla Ice had slept with Jamie and Donny. Todd leaves the wedding with Donny. Todd now feels happy with Donny and says he wants to help him avoid going to jail. Donny insists that he is responsible for his actions and does not want to be paid money. Johnny's friend appears and turns on the television. Donny plays $20 on a fat man who was running well in the marathon. Donny appears to be in with a chance of winning his bet. Unexpectedly, the fat man wins the race and passes all the runners in front of him. Donny won $160,000 with the $20 he had bet. Donny does not have to go to prison in the end. The movie ends with everyone cheering. Thank you for watching. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any of our videos.